Hey K-Babes! So about a year ago, I put up my very first What's on My iPhone video, and since then I've gotten a ton of questions on, Kayla, can you please do an update of What's on My iPhone? Please, 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 please! So today I'm here with that. I did want to do this whole like fancy, like I'll show you what's on my iPhone on a different screen, but the program I downloaded for it, for some reason I deleted it, which is really dumb. But I don't have time to download it right now, and I have to go into work in like an hour. So we're just gonna do this, okay? So a year ago I had bought this exact iPhone, and since then it is cracked. So we're just gonna have to deal with that, okay? We're gonna just So there's a crack. Say crack one more time. Crack. Okay, so we're just gonna get into this, and yeah, because last time mine was like 13 minutes long. That was way too long. So when you click the little home button, and this is a regular 5, when you click the home button, Olaf is in the front.
Hi, I'm Olaf.
And it's currently 3:57. I have to work at 5. So technically an hour and 3 minutes I have to go into work. But Olaf's on the front, and then if you slide it, I don't have a passcode, and it's actually on the second page. I don't have a passcode, so yeah, so you can just like get into it. Anybody who wants to steal it, you can just steal it and get into it. I don't know why I don't have a passcode, but I want to get the iPhone 5S or just wait for the 6 so I can do the whole thumbprint thing, because that's pretty darn cool. Okay, so on my home screen I have messages, calendar, photos, camera, videos, maps, weather, passbook, notes, reminders, clocks, docs, newsstand, iTunes store, app store, game center, settings, FaceTime. And then the first four, the main four things are phone, mail, Safari, and music. Now everything is pretty much self-explanatory. The only thing I would have to say is, oh, passbook. I figured out it's where you can put like your plane tickets and coupons and stuff. And you can basically, you can just like scan it from here. So it's like, oh, I have my ticket here on my phone, which is pretty cool. So no, let's go back. So other than that, I think the most used ones on here would be my messages and clock. And then obviously camera and more photos. I take a lot of pictures, but I don't take a lot of selfies. I take a lot of pictures, like random pictures and screenshots. It's really weird. Okay, so on, if you slide over to the second screen, I only have 2 screens. I never used to like folders, but it was just too much for my phone, so I started putting stuff into folders, and now I actually like folders. So the first one is utilities, the next one is social media, lifestyle, hot schedules, entertainment, arcade, editing, productivity, finance, travel, GroupMe, Livocracy, Fonto, Goodreads, Spotify, and TimerCam. On utilities, I have contacts, calculator, compass, and voice memos, and when you upgrade to iOS 7, it has this with it. Social media, I have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Pinterest, Kick, and Vine. And also Snapchat, which I didn't like, and I still kind of am okay with it, but I have it. So yeah. Then in lifestyle, I have podcasts, Find Friends, iBooks, and Find iPhone, which I recommend if you have an iPhone and an iPad or some other i-something. I would recommend putting in Find iPhone, because if you lose it, you can find it and go stalk the person and kill them and then get your phone back. Because that's what I would do. Nah. Hot schedules is for work. It's where they post up the schedule, and if you want to swap with somebody, you can swap. Or if you need to release your schedule and tell people like, hey, can you pick it up because I have this and this today, you can do that on here. They don't post up a schedule anywhere inside of work. Like when you go to work, there's no schedule up. The schedule is on your phone or online. You have to go look at it. And if you don't, then, and you don't show up for work, it's your fault because you're supposed to be responsible for that. Entertainment, I have Flixster, SoundHound, and Netflix. Flixster is pretty cool because I just love this app. My boyfriend and I both have this app, and it's just really cool. I talked about this last time. If you're looking for movie times, I used to go through, before they had this, I used to go through the newspaper and look for movie times, because we wouldn't have, like, we wouldn't have any of this. And also, if you didn't have a newspaper, if you don't want to go through a newspaper, you'd go online and look for movie times. for the closest theater. Here you can find theaters near you, like it'll tell you all of the theaters that are near you and then all of their movie times. You can even purchase tickets from Flixster, which is really cool. SoundHound is like Shazam, but I don't like Shazam. My boyfriend has Shazam, and he says it's really good, but I like SoundHound better, even though Shazam probably is better, but I just like SoundHound. It's Netflix, pretty self-explanatory. I have Netflix, and I didn't really like Netflix before because they would have like the stupidest movies on there and they wouldn't have up-to-date like movies and shows. Now they do, so I'm starting to like Netflix a lot better. And Arcade, I don't use this at all. I don't use it unless I'm super bored. I have Candy Crush and GameStop. I used to have more games, but I realized that it was taking up space on my phone because I don't play games on my phone. Like, I just don't. I get on my social media. And then GameStop is for when I want to go buy games, which I sold my PS3, so... Editing, I have Picture Frame, Labelbox, Faded, and Afterlight. Now, I'm pretty sure you've heard of PicFrame, sorry. PicFrame and Afterlight, PicFrame is just a collage where you can make collages and pretty cool stuff. Afterlight is where I edit some of my photos, but I mainly go through Faded. Afterlight is just the same thing as Faded, but Faded's like Afterlight on steroids. That's what I after like Faded is just a new Afterlight. Afterlight, you can put all your filters. You can put your filters, anything like that on your photos, crop them, do whatever you want to them, put a different color. I don't know, whatever your life is. Maybe you're a Smurf. I don't know. Labelbox is where you can just put a label over something. And then Faded, of course, is like my all-time favorite photo editing app for Instagram. I put all of my filters, anything, I go through Faded. Faded is like the best app that I have on here, hands down. It's pretty awesome. And some people use Whittagram to put like the entire photo on your Instagram, but you can actually do it through Faded too, because they have like a frame for that, which is pretty cool. In productivity, I have My Day, Listery, Docs2Go, and Blogger. My Day is for like really cool stuff, say like my birthday, my 21st birthday, I had a countdown. And I had a countdown for like 4 months, and it said like 4 months and 30 some days or whatever, you know, like that kind of stuff. I had one for Generation Beauty, but I didn't go after all, we changed our minds. I had one for Vegas, when I went to Vegas. Listery is where you just put a bunch of lists. I have like videos I need to film, saving, what I need to save for, and random things, like if I need a pack for something, I have it there. Docs2Go is pretty cool because if I need to write an essay while I'm on the go, I legit like wrote an essay while I was on a car ride. Like it was an hour ride and I needed to do homework that was due that night, so I wrote an essay on my phone, which was pretty cool. Blogger, I have a blog. I have a beauty blog, but I don't get on it as much. I really use it for my BookTube blogging because I like to blog my books that I review. Granted, when I do beauty videos and my BookTube videos, it's really hard for me to read a lot of books, so I don't read a lot of books as all the other BookTubers, but I've been reading and reviewing books as I go. I need to put like 3 reviews up. That's pretty bad. I need to put 3 reviews up, but I do I do write my reviews in this book, so whenever I'm going to put it up on my blogger or make a review for BookTube, I have it all written down in this Hello Kitty notebook, which is pretty cool. Finance, I have my banking, so I have Bank of America. I'm not going to go into that because it has personal info in there. And then my BillGuard, I'm not going to go into that either. BillGuard's pretty cool because it can tell you if you purchase something, it'll confirm with you, did you purchase this or did somebody steal your card? So that's how I know if somebody has stolen my number or anything like that, or has my information, which is pretty cool, so that they can't go buying anything. Travel, I just have Expedia and Kayak for whenever I want to find hotels or anything at discounted prices. GroupMe is for work. I really don't use it. It's just for work. Because I am a trainer, I got promoted at work, so the trainers tend to message each other through this app. Lovocracy is pretty cool. Lovocracy is a really cool place. Like, I don't know if it's easy to find things that you really are looking for, but I can see what other people are loving and buying, and if I really love it, I can buy it from there. And the cool thing about Lovocracy is that it'll find the cheapest price for you at any website that you'll get it for sure. Like, it'll just find the cheapest price, which is pretty cool. So So if you want to know my Lovocracy, I'll have it down below and you can go follow me and check out the things that I've been loving. The next thing I have is Fonto, and Fonto is, I bought it for, did I buy it? I can't remember if I buy these apps or not, honestly. But I got it for the Nyx Face Awards when I wanted to put vote for Kayla, Nyx Face Awards Top 20. And I put it on my Instagram, if you saw that, where it had the Christina Aguilera and it says vote for Kayla Top 20. Goodreads is for BookTube. Goodreads is where I connect with other BookTubers and also find what other people are loving and reading. And I joined some groups so that I know what to film for BookTube and stuff, which I haven't gotten on. But I need to start filming some of the videos that they have been requesting, or not requesting, but like they film too. Spotify is pretty cool. Spotify is a great app for where you can get tons of music for $9.99 a month, which is pretty awesome. I have a few playlists up and I will link my Spotify down below so you guys can check it out and follow me if you'd like, because you know, the music I listen to is pretty awesome. So yeah. Time Creme is something I just recently got because I saw My Life as Ava with this on her phone. So I've always had that where I want to take a selfie, but have you ever tried to like take the selfie with the button and as you're pushing the button, it shakes the camera so it's all blurry and I hate it. So I'm glad I got Timer Cam because Timer Cam can take the selfie for me. I can set it to however many seconds I want to and then just take the picture and I'm done. Alright, so that is it for, that's all on my iPhone, and I forgot to show you guys or tell you guys that my background just got changed from like some Victorian purple background to a summer one because it is summertime, so I decided to do that, but I'm still gonna leave the home screen as Olaf because Olaf is cool. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and also thumbs up this video if you're excited for my summer videos that are coming up because I just bought some new filming equipment and you'll be seeing greater videos coming up, also because I have my boyfriend help me now. So yeah, I'm really excited for new videos, and yeah, also don't forget to follow me on Twitter and Instagram. So well, mainly Twitter, because Twitter is when I'm updating people and when I'm uploading and asking people what they want to see, because I'd rather put up what you guys want to see, not what I want to see. So yeah, be sure to follow me down there and I'll have everything down below, and I will see you guys again very soon. Bye. Baby, come back.